In this video, I'm talking about a big picture overview of how business communication changed in history. I'm talking about some big elements. So, long time ago, when people lived in small villages and everybody knew everybody, people communicated directly face to face. So let's say if there was a baker, the baker knew all the customers, and the customers could give back feedback immediately and make some change. The baker could make some changes in the process. Okay, but in the 20th century, everything changed. The mass production came, and the customers were regarded as a big mess. People who want the same thing. So there were not too many options. And even if a company provided different options, it was basically mainly about guessing what they want. So not about us asking and talking to people day by day and getting their feedback, because there were no technology for this one. Maybe they made some research, market research, to give this job maybe to a department or to an outsider or a company outside, a market research company, but those are not very reliable researches. So in the 20th century, mainly what happened, it was one-way communication. So big companies, they advertise in newspaper, radio, television, billboards, posters, sending their messages that this is my product, buy this product because, and some reasons. But there were not too much two-way communication to getting feedback from the customers. But in the 21st century, with the internet, the things changed. And two-way communication is possible and it's spreading. More and more company has social media presence, and they let the people to express their opinion, ask questions, and they delegate some people, maybe marketing or customer service people, to answer questions, so they can get quickly, they can quick feedback from people. So they have a product, and if a lot of people start to complain, then maybe they take it seriously and change it. Or what is the best thing, that people can very easily send their recommendation. I also do this a lot of times for software, that I want this feature, I want that feature. So if you are a business owner or a marketing manager at the company, think about this, that if you haven't established this social media presence like Facebook, then do it, because the huge benefit is that you can innovate much faster. You get almost instant feedback from the customers, what they want. Okay, you don't have to guess anymore. You don't have to pay money for outsiders, for market research company, to make some fake reports that this is what the customers want. You can directly communicate with your customers. So the two-way communication, the businesses can ask questions, what do you want, and people, the customers, they can complain and they can recommend new features in the product. This is a huge opportunity to very quickly be able to respond to people's desire. And then there is another topic, what is happening in the business world. There are more and more free products online. So this is a new phenomenon that earlier, let's say that if you went to a supermarket, sometimes they gave you some free sample, you can taste this, okay? But I'm talking about that, let's say almost all of the software is free. There is a free version, open source softwares. So yes, you can buy usually Microsoft products or any other companies that they sell the their products for money, but a new social initiative came out from the internet. One is that people produce free stuff. If you just look at YouTube, so many very useful videos are available free, and people work very hard to get the potential customers or the viewers' attention, and they give a lot of tutorials, for example, free. You can learn how to program computer softwares. They are free. So understand this. It's about mainly information. So something that can be digitalized and spread almost freely, actually it's free, or even you can get money for advertising. But there is a new element of the business. It's emerging more and more, the free economy. People produce videos like this video to people they want to give. Maybe they, of course, hope that in long term somehow it will help in their business, but there are many businesses and individuals who enjoy creating a lot of new stuff, and they don't want anything back. They don't want anything. Yes, there are different combinations that you provide some basic software or products or information free, and this is the first stage for your getting paying customers. Or maybe you get an update, so you provide the software, it's free, and then you can have a better version and pay money. So understand this. A lot of businesses disappear because people are willing to provide services, products, softwares, give advice free. So be aware of this when you have a long-term business strategy. I heard a story about Microsoft when they were creating an encyclopedia, and they planned to create CDs or DVDs and sell, so you don't have to buy the paper encyclopedia, the thick books, you can just have a software. But then Wikipedia came, and their whole business idea just proved wrong, because a lot of people are willing to contribute to Wikipedia to give information, and the whole community, a lot of people together creates. So this is also a new phenomenon, that not just individual or companies create things, but people cooperate, because the internet made it possible. So when you have a business strategy, you should think about incorporating free elements. Because if you don't do this, others will do. And be very aware in long-term thinking that, is it possible that you plan something, invest a lot of money, and somebody else will provide this free in the same quality? And then all of your hard work and investment is just total waste. Okay? So when you have a business strategy, or you are the marketing department leader of a company, or the CEO of a company, then think about this. There are a lot of free things online, and there will be more and more, especially when the production is free, so it's not a physical product, but ideas in the mind products, and it can be distributed free. Then be aware that the free competition will take away your business. And what was the first one before is that utilize the two-way communication to get in picture what people really want, and that is a huge value, because earlier companies just guessed what people want. They had some information, what did they buy, so, but it's only about what they already provided for them, and they could choose that I don't like A, I like B. But with this two-way communication, you don't have to produce first. You can ask, and if many people say that I want this feature in the product, then probably it's a good marketing decision to provide that feature.